Well, thank you, Christian, for that message. Thank you, Trevor, for sharing so openly. I really appreciate that. And now, like Christian said, we are in May and it's our month of missions giving. And so we have Olia here, originally from Moscow, but now you're in the Potomac Valley in Virginia. So if you could just share with us about your experience in the church in Russia.
My story started with my mom getting baptized in 92, and as you know, like Soviet Union started at 1991, and I was born in 1990, and so in 1991 she actually got cancer, and she was told that she's gonna die, that doctors cannot heal her, and she read the story about Hannah and how Hannah promised God will keep her alive, then she will devote her child to God. And so she decided to do the same and just promised that if God will keep her alive, she will devote me to God, which she didn't know by the time what it will mean, but she promised that anyway. And she got healed and no one could understand how. And the same year, the church in Moscow was planted and her best friend invited her to church to take communion, and she became disciple. And so after that, I was praying for a while for me to have dad, because she was a single mom. And in 1996 she got married, and her husband, he adopted me, he raised me as his daughter, and I'm the only child. So by the time I get into teens, it was like very easy for me to make decision to become a disciple, because it was like very obvious for me that God exists, and if God exists, like, you want to be on his side, not the other side. So, and I'm like, yes, please baptize me, like, I want to study Bible. like, my story is very tied to that background.
And so can you explain a little bit, because you said the church was planted and your mom became a disciple, and then when you grew up and you were a teenager, it was easy for you to make that decision, but in Russia, is it common for people to be Christians? Like, is that normal?
So it wasn't at that time. I think right now, a lot of times, Russian identity is tied to Orthodox, because it's part of that is like tied to government as well. So a lot of time when you ask if a person is Christian, they say, I'm Orthodox, I'm Russian, so I'm Orthodox. Like, it's acceptable, but at the same time, they're not necessarily even know what it means to be Christian. But at that time, it wasn't like that. And so the fact that our church came and were able to help people to study Bible and to understand what it means to be Christian, it was very powerful.
Wow. And how has your journey been since then? Because you said your parents are disciples, you became a disciple as a teenager, but then going forward, it seems like you had a church family, but how did that play a role kind of as you grew up? You said it was easy at first to get baptized, but then
I think later at my 20s, that's when I had to mature and separate my faith from my parents, and that's where I had more questions and started searching. And I was about to leave the church, but there were other disciples that were able to help me and just first of all accept me where I am and have conversations with me and address my doubts, and also show that God is graceful, because at that time, I grew up with a mind that I didn't understand that God is graceful as much as more I was trained to obey. And so I think at that time it was more shown he's actually graceful and what that means, and empathize on that.
Mm-hmm. That's amazing. And so now you're in Virginia. How did you get there? Why did you move to Virginia?
Yeah. So in 2015, I moved for a 1 year challenge, actually, which is a program where you devote 1 year of your life to God. And so I moved to Kansas. So Lawrence, I know some of you might know Heartland. Texas is connected to Heartland. Yeah. I moved there and was starting there for Young Professionals Campus Ministry. And after that, I also moved to Virginia because I had some connections there. And I also served there leading a singles ministry, and then I stayed there.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So you were in Kansas for a year, and then you've been in Virginia since then. Wow, that's awesome. Are you happy to be here?
Yeah, for sure.
Oh, that's awesome. So the last thing that I wanted to ask is just, do you feel like in all of this, that you have a personal connection to missions or kind of how it's affected your life?
Well, I think it just, like, my life wouldn't be the way it is if there would be no people who planted the church, who invested, like, their life, their time, their money into coming and planting that. So that's, vital.
That's amazing. And then you came here and decided to give here. So that's amazing. We appreciate you
for
coming and giving in the Heartland and even in Virginia now where you are. Thank you so much just for sharing where you come from and your journey. I'm really grateful that you're here because I know for me personally, sometimes I can hear missions and I'm like, yeah, okay, I'll give some money and hopefully it helps something. But to see that it has a lasting impact, like I obviously wasn't giving at the time that the church was planted, but to know that giving and enabling other Christians to go and to share their faith, I mean, that enables just generations of people because there's your mom and then you, and then now you're helping others even here. And so I'm really grateful that you're here to share that with us. I hope that it inspires everyone and just encourages us that really when we give, like, God uses it. So thank you so much for being
here. Thank you.